Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to drill 5 lug Z32 rotors to fit 4 lug 240SX. First thing you want to do is identify where you're going to put the holes. If we start with this hole here, we're going to put a hole here, here, and here. The hole on the bottom is going to be too close to this hole. If we rotate it, we'll have here, 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 and here. That'll actually work out perfectly, so that's the one we're going to keep. We're going to use this template that I created to drill the holes. This template's available online. Just go into the video description, there'll be a link for it. So now that we've identified where we're going to put the holes, we need to lay the template. I'm using washable school glue. Put it on, wipes right off. You're going to apply it around the face of the rotor. That just ensures that when you lay the template on, it actually stays in place for the entire time. Now that I have the center cut out, I'm also going to measure from the center punch mark to the bore hole. I want to make sure that they're the same all around, and that'll tell me if this is centered or how far off it is. So I got 19.97. 19.97. That one is right on point. And that one is on point. I know that this one's going to be good because that's the factory hole. We got everything set. We're going to center punch now. Alright, we got our punches in, they're all dead on. Time to move this over to the press. I have the bit chucked in, it's tight, the rotor's clamped down, I have it lined up the first hole we're going to drill. Before I actually start, because this is cast iron, we don't lubricate. The chamfer is a slight bevel. If you look at all the factory holes, including the center bore, there's a slight bevel around each of the 6 holes. We want to add it to the 3 holes that we cut because that will relieve stress on the rotor and it'll prevent cracking. To do that, we're going to use a chamfering bit. I'll get that chucked in.
We have the wheel off. We're going to temporarily test fit this. I want to show you how simple this is to actually do using a template. It's a perfect fit. You don't need any special tools. You just need some patience. If you like this video, please subscribe.